Well, Charlie, I suppose the Ghost Club holds some new horror for me today?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me. Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, Beware All Those Who Enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. I'm eager to begin. You're not afraid. Another legend claims the attic is haunted by the spirit of a young woman who purportedly threw herself from the top floor windows to escape her abusive uncle. Her screaming ghost has reportedly been sighted hanging from the window ledge. This residence was briefly owned by Mr. James Jasper, a choir master and an opium addict. His nephew Edward was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress.
That's a girl.
Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. Although eerie, this phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic, his only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. A sudden draft, nothing more. My word, perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
Hehehehe.
Why would you hang in around that house?
What's it to you?
Tell me or I'll drag it out of you.
All right. We were there for the treasure. We found a key to the secret passage.
Secret passage?
Yeah. Number 50's got a secret passage.
Something's going
on. Here, take it. Just leave me be.
I've found a lock, but I haven't located the key.
Lucky for you, I've got it.
Ha! So this is how it works.
How disappointingly dull.
Came near to equaling mine. It should have been enough to keep my beloved nephew away. My poor Ned. Forgive.
Alas, the myth has been discredited. There was no ghost in Berkeley Square, just a wretched soul driven to murder and madness by guilt and intoxication. I think this is the makings of a rather fine novel. I wonder if I've got one left in me.
Let me hunt.
now. Come on.
There's been a spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
They look like common robberies at first, but these perpetrators have all claimed to have been under the influence of some supernatural power. I'm not so foolish as to forget that criminals will spin any yarn to avoid the law. However, these thieves all proffer the same defense. They say they were being controlled by a demon. Will you make some inquiries? One of our demon-possessed mobsmen is being held behind bars at this very moment. You may want to begin your search there.
It's really as simple as that.
Shouldn't you be at home with her then?
What's that man done?
Robbed the pawnbrokers down the road.
A demon made me do it. I can't remember much. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you. Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a silver watch, swinging in midair. It was held by someone or something. A dark presence whispering. I could only see its eyes. A demon.
I'll need to verify this with the shopkeeper.
Thank you.
What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same cellar. Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his. A lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
You took something from a pawn shop.
It's all very hazy, but I remember something silver flashing in front of my eyes. Then I heard a sort of bell. Next thing I know, I'm here with you.
My only lead is this mysterious buyer. This chap might lead me to the demon.
Better take a look.
Teach you a lesson!
You just run along now.
Mm.
That's it, girl. Onward. Get up.
Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness, what foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft. How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken.
Oh!
Have you truly no recollection of the events that landed you in a cell?
My mind is blank, save for the glint of a silver object, the toll of a bell, and a presence of some sort.
A glint of silver and a tolling bell. I must say, you look very tired.
Yes. I'm so very, very tired.
Now you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
Now I'm going to do a little job of work for you.
You've cost me a bit of money, mate. So I think it's only fair that you replenish my coffers with donations from the good people of London. You will steal money for me, won't you?
Yes. I will steal money for you.
Good. Very good. Now, we can't have criminals like you roaming the streets. You will surrender to the police, won't you?
Yes, I will surrender to the police.
Oh, and when you do, you're going to do a silly little dance for them.
Ezio.
I was hypnotized by Ezio Capelli, not a demon after all. Nor Italian, for that matter.
are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Thank you.
Keep an eye out for valuables.
I shall look over here.
My child.
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
See that I'm not disturbed.
Mr. Capelli says I won't remember this when I'm finished.
I'm not Italian. It was just for my act. Nobody wanted to see a British hypnotist.
I don't care.
I'll give you anything you want.
I would like you to be quiet. Are you a contemporary of Dr. Elliotson?
Never heard of them.
Mesmerism as a criminal enterprise was not a bright idea.
How dare you? I'm a hypnotist.
We mustn't allow anyone to get near Mr. Capelli.
Thank you.
We mustn't allow anyone to get near Mr. Capelli.
Mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Mr. Capelli says I won't remember this when I'm finished.
You are very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. Aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Give you anything you want.
I would like you to be quiet. Are you a contemporary of Dr.
Not again! Never heard of the man.
Mesmerism as a criminal enterprise was not a bright idea.
How dare you! I'm a hypnotist!
don't you? I admit it.
I don't...
I made you let me go. I'll give you anything you want.
I would like you to be quiet. Are you...
Keep an eye out for valuables.
Thank you.
Very much mistaken. Aren't you my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Mistaken. Aren't you my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Looking for money.
Very much mistaken. Aren't you my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Mr. Capelli says I won't remember this when I'm finished.
are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
Take anything. See that I'm not disturbed.
I admit it! I had time to disappear.
I doubt you can escape me. You're a better criminal than athlete. What are you thinking?
This is really quite painful. Not work out an arrangement.
You will make reparations for your crimes and liberate the innocents you've used.